Representing the Henderson Chamber this morning is President and COO of Field & Main, Doug Lawson. Good morning, Doug.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm very good. How are things going with you at Field & Main during this pandemic?
Very good. Very interesting. We've had lots of entertaining discussions trying to make sure we're taking care of our people and our community. The rules are always a work in progress, but we're proud to try and do our part. And just important to kind of keep each other safe and be proactive. But it has been an interesting year. We basically took last year's business plan, chunked it out the window in March, and have been going by the seat of our pants and a little bit of common sense since then. But it's worked out really well. So.
Well, it's what everybody had to do. I think we've heard the word pivot way too many times. Everybody's had to pivot, and, you know, that's what we do. So let's talk today about the impact of this coronavirus on local small businesses and what is being done to respond?
Sure. Well, certainly our small businesses are really finding new ways to be creative. We've seen some businesses actually flourish. Others have really struggled. No one really knows what a good pandemic will do until you're in the middle of one. But as far as our communities are concerned, I feel like that our small businesses are they're making their way through. We're going to lose some, and that's a sad reality, and we're trying to work with as many folks as we can on the bank and through the chamber especially. And our chamber was very, very active early on in the pandemic with community, social media information, and we're doing a daily Zoom call for our local businesses just to talk. And I think the ability to communicate was reassuring for some folks. It helped them analyze whether it was a PPP loan that came through the CARES Act or even an EIDL emergency loan. Some of those were taken. But I think the early efforts of our business community really resulted in a calm that was necessary to get through the pandemic. And so where folks were really nervous in the beginning, we've seemed to be rational in our thought throughout this and our small business community. Really just is resilient, and I'm really proud of how they've reacted during this time. And if someone is down, they tend to try and help each other out, which has been very reassuring.
And I think we see that. We've seen that in all of our tri-state communities. Were there businesses that are now on hold that were planning to open, say, in the last 8 months that have had to wait to see what happens next?
Yes, I believe that there are some that that are still continuing to modify their business plan, just like we modified ours at the bank. We had to kind of readjust. You know, things changed as far as like work from home is a completely new endeavor, and we found a very high level of productivity. But it was a necessary change to protect our folks. Other small businesses have figured out how to use technology to their advantage. Don't waste a good crisis is what we've said. Make sure that you're analyzing everything. And in the end, the pandemic, there will be some good things that actually come from. What we need to do, though, is try and help those who the pandemic is some particular business segments are more deeply affected than others. We're trying to help them as well.
So. Well, it sounds like you're doing everything you can. And Doug, I'm going to borrow that line from you and make a T-shirt. Don't waste a good pandemic. The Henderson Chamber can sell those. Thank you so much.
If it works, if it'll sell, I'm all in.
Thank you, Doug. It's good to see you.
All right. Take care. Have a great day.
Thank you. You too. We'll be back with more local lifestyles right after this.